welcome to your September reading. Thank you for watching. If you haven't already, watch your Virgo season all signs video and then come back here. I don't know why that's such a tongue twister for me. So I've been meditating on your energy. I love Pisces energy. So Pisces for Virgo season. I will note now that I'm saving all the details of what I'm doing and what you have to look forward to for the end of the video. I started filming at the beginning of the zodiac because I did take a little hiatus. So this is the last of the zodiac. Pisces is very empathetic, which you probably already know if you're a Pisces. Let's get into your reading and I'll save the details for the end. It's Virgo season. Pisces. So, if we have not overcome enough through the eclipses and Cancer season, basically since our own season, Pisces, there is a sense of accomplishment in Virgo season by the end of it. All right. So a few cards fell out. This isn't the bottom of the deck. This flipped out on top. It's the Ace of Swords. Okay. Let's go through these together. The ones that fell out. We have the Five of Cups, the Ace of Pentacles, and the Eight of Cups. Okay. This is a financial situation, a physical relocating for Pisces over something draining emotionally and hopefully by your full moon you will have the everything that you need to move forward in the direction that you need to go. Okay. Full moon is on the 14th. If you want to take notes, get pen and paper. I read very intuitively, so write down anything that resonates with you that you want to look further into. And yes. Okay. Let's slow down. We have the Ace of Swords. The abilities to make quick and healthy decisions. Solid, confident decisions. What does Virgo offer us? Virgo offers us, right in the middle of everything, stability, new opportunities. I'm trying to hold this so the light isn't. Okay. They're just shiny cards, okay? Oh, this light. I don't know why I said that. This coin. That's so reflective, okay, that I'm completely distracted by. That is Virgo stability for you to move forward, okay? If you want to utilize Virgo's energy to get you in a more foundational place, Pisces, you are going to really need to look at the current situation you're in, okay? Because right here, you're not at a complete loss. You're upset about some things and you don't want to be, you don't want to be around that anymore. Here we are moving, okay? And the Eight of Cups, we're definitely moving towards something. So when this is an emotional, meets your mental meets your physical work, okay, during Virgo season, when you clean up the mess of what it is that you're currently in. And I don't want to say it's a mess as in it's just irreparable, okay, but you're not feeling good and it's a little messy. So Virgo urges us to look for the new opportunities, okay? Look for the signs that you're exactly where you need to be, because the situation around you is just conditional and it's going to clean up once you find your focus, where you're happy focusing. And this is someplace that makes you feel safe, it makes you feel abundant, and it makes you feel like you're really doing it, you're really making something of this thing that you've been working on or this new opportunity. To do so requires some understanding, some deeper understanding of Pisces, of what this physical world actually means. Because why is everybody taking everything so serious anyway? You know, this is gonna happen, it's just gonna go like this. Okay, you're very intuitive, but you do not know how things will play out. And especially when you're moving from a spilled cup kind of place, you're gonna move right back into the same thing, okay? So understand this is a slower energy, and this is a big fat seed that you're gonna plant and then see the fruit of that later this year in the winter, okay? Really for quite a while. So this is framework that we're doing in Virgo season. Foundational stuff to support what it is that we're dreaming about and what it is that we are creating and want to bring into the physical life. Our idea is made solid, okay? It's not an overnight process. This does require some grounding. As a Pisces, as a mutable water sign, okay, you will find great balance just being in nature. There's plenty of different ways to go about grounding yourself, but I really encourage you to get outside if you're in the Northern Hemisphere and it's still warm and nice outside. I very much encourage you to do so. You can even lay in the grass and stare at the clouds, okay? And maybe you'll be inspired to something even better. Maybe you'll be inspired to your first step of your first plan of action towards what it is that you want to manifest so bad. Okay, it's really important that we don't get stuck in conditional emotions, okay? Things will happen around us forever, okay, so long as we're here, and our emotional response to them is our power, essentially. So the things that you're looking at, those spilt cups, are gonna make you know, if you look at them for too long, they're gonna make you make decisions that take you right back to a very similar situation, and you're gonna find yourself repeating yourself over until you grasp what it is that we're actually working towards, okay? Career-wise, if you haven't already been promoted or had that new opportunity come up, wait for it. If it has not come up, then it's probably due to you not looking at it. I'm sure it's right there. Maybe somebody offered you something and you've been too focused on the things going wrong that you sat on it. And, you know, hopefully, I'm not saying there won't be the next opportunity, okay? But if you forgot about it, you know, then it's still there. You're having a tendency to, let me keep shuffling. Okay, I want to keep shuffling. So what we know about Virgo, especially with Virgo and Mercury, there's a lot of Earth signs in the stars right now. There's a lot of planets in Earth signs. And it can make everything seem really serious, you know, to the rest of the zodiac. And as empathetic as you are, you know, sometimes you really need to make it a daily routine or fit to your needs to clear your energy and to let go of things. Make a small ritual of it, make a big ritual of it. The full moon is always a great time to let go of things, and really that's the new moon, but I mean, you don't want to hold on to things through the full moon if that's not what you're about. So things that we need to let go of, probably from Cancer season. It's making space. It's making space, and the space is filling in quite quickly with solid, physical, real-life manifestations. Okay. Let this be a good thing. Let this be a good thing. So through that groundedness, you're charged to the point where you're confident, you're clear, and execute the first steps towards what it is that you're moving towards so fast. Okay, bottom of the deck is the Wheel of Fortune. Things are at an ever-changing rate. Things are always changing, even on a molecular, cellular level. Everything's always changing, right? So what came out? If we didn't, okay. So that's Major Arcana. Two more. The Empress and Judgment. Okay. Everybody feels as if they're under a magnifying glass, rather that be from the public or their own. What matters is more the substance underneath the glass, okay? And that's the Empress energy. So right now is a very fertile time for manifestations, for seeds to be planted, you know, theoretical seeds, okay, towards your goals, okay? Because this is also established, okay? This is an establishment. She is the Empress. There is a lot that goes on before she gets that throne, right? Is there no work put into being an Empress, okay? Is there no responsibility that comes along with that? Of course there is. That's what I'm getting to. Not just what you can gain materially this season, but the things that you're being called to put into place and build the framework of that. It's a baby step towards a greater ruling, a greater position, a more abundant and loving and happy position, okay? So it will take some work. It will take some work, and the work isn't going to last forever, but what you do now will last you a long time. The things you do to benefit you in the future, career-wise especially, okay? I get into relationship stuff a little bit more in the extended. I don't have a whole lot to say at this moment for Pisces in relationships or single, but your extended will be available when they're ready. You are the last sign, and so I am doing the extendeds after this. Everyone's video is now out, and you guys really have such a okay, so Virgo season on the 14th. The full moon in Pisces is bringing the spirit to body, the mind to body, sort of. The other, just the dreamlike dimensions that you know, not everybody experiences, not everybody believes in. Logic can really chip away at imagination and playfulness. And too much logic is not very fun, okay? So, of all the zodiac signs, I know you're going through a lot, but when you're at your best, you don't understand the power that you have in a room, Pisces, to brighten everyone's day, okay? It matters a lot what's going in with you, what's going on with you, and I know most Pisces just want to help everyone too, and that's the best way you're going to be able to help everyone this month, is by focusing on your stability emotionally and financially and getting clear on some goals, specifics. Okay, now is the time for specifics. Now is the time to bring the non-physical into the physical, okay? So I'm going to pull an oracle card before we go, and then you can check back here for your extendeds when they're ready. When I get the link, I'll put it in the box below, so hit subscribe and the bell notification if you want to stay posted with that. And what else? Yes, Libra season. Next season, we'll work more on our balance of everything, okay? Our balance between taking things seriously and daydreaming and mushing it all together. We'll find the balance of that in Libra. Pisces, your card is ego. Okay. I will read it for you. A false sense of entrapment, being overly focused on material things, negative or fear-based thoughts. Okay, that is not the place to operate from. Now we know, we've had our confirmation. You are not trapped. You are not confined, but you know, you're not a fish out of water right now. And you have everything that you need. Stop looking around you for those, okay, the material things. I'm telling you, they do matter, okay? It's the condition of what's going on inside you. You can always find out what's going on inside of you based on your surroundings, okay? Because that takes us out of the victim mentality. That makes us responsible for our emotions and our decisions, and it's happier. This is not a fun place to operate from. Fear-based thoughts, negative thoughts, don't cycle back around. So we'll get more into it during the extended, and thank you so much for watching. Love you all, and see you soon.